Hello guys, let's just discuss one of the theory part related with bevel gear, that is pitch cone angles and its geometrical relationship. Now we know that this gamma 1 and gamma 2 are the pitch cone angle of gear 1 and gear 2. It is angle between pitch cone element to the axis of gear. So here is the gamma 1 plus gamma 2, and that is equal to theta, that is the shaft angle. So before we start, let's just see the nomenclature. Theta is the shaft angle, that is equal to gamma 1 plus gamma 2. Gamma 1 and gamma 2 are the pitch cone angles of bevel gear 1 and 2. T1 and T2 are the number of teeth of gear 1 and 2. Omega 1 and omega 2 is the angular velocity of gear 1 and 2. R1 and R2 is the pitch circle radius of bevel gear 1 and 2. Now let's just start from gear ratio. We know that gear ratio G is equal to T2 by T1 is equal to R2 by R1 is equal to N1 upon N2 or omega 1 upon omega 2. That number of teeth is inversely proportional to the RPM. So now from figure, let's just write the equation for OP in terms of gamma and R. So OP, see here we get this triangle, this front side is R and this angle is gamma 1. So we can write for OP, it is R1 divided by sine of gamma 1. So OP is equal to R1 divided by sine of gamma 1. Similarly, see this OP and this. So for OP, here we have the R2 and here we have gamma 2. So we can write R2 divided by sine of gamma 2. So let's just rearrange this term, that is sine of gamma 1. Let's take on another side. So it becomes sine of gamma 1 upon sine of gamma 2 is equal to R1 upon R2. So sine of gamma 1 is equal to R1 upon R2 sine of gamma 2. Now see, we know that this sine of gamma 2 is what? Theta minus of sine of gamma 1. So sine of gamma 2 is theta minus of gamma 1. So now let's just use mathematical formula for that sine A minus B. So it is sine A into cos B minus of cos A into sine B. So here we have theta minus of gamma. So sine theta into cos of gamma minus of cos theta into sine of gamma, remaining term as it is. Now let's divide both side by cos of gamma 1. So we get sine of gamma 1 divided by cos of gamma 1 is equal to R1 divided by R2. Now inside the bracket, so here cos of gamma 1 cos of gamma 1 get cancelled. So sine theta by cos sine theta minus of cos theta, here sine gamma 1 divided by cos of gamma 1. Okay, so sine divided by cos is tan. So tan of gamma 1 is equal to R1 upon R2 sine theta cos theta as it is. Again here sine upon cos is tan. So let's just shift this R1 upon R2 on another side. It becomes R2 divided by R1 tan of gamma 1. This bracket remains as it is. Now again, as you can see in this, we have two common terms two terms we have a common term, tan of gamma 1. So let's just shift this term on another side. We get R2 upon R1 tan of gamma 1 as it is plus cos theta tan of gamma 1. This sine theta is remains as it is. Now let's just take this tan of gamma 1 common. So we get tan of gamma 1 inside the bracket R2 upon R1 plus cos theta. Now we are interested in pitch cone angles and its geometrical relation. Tan of gamma 1 is equal to, so let's just move this term on another side. So it become sine theta divided by R2 upon R1 plus cos of theta. And when we are going to replace this R2 by R1 in terms of omega, it become omega 1 upon omega 2. Because this radius is inversely proportional to the omega, angular velocity, or we can say that in terms of n rpm is there, it is also n1 upon n2. Similarly, we can able to write formula for gamma 2. So it is tan of gamma 2, sin theta remains as it is. Only instead of this omega 1 upon omega 2, here we get omega 2 upon omega 1 plus cos theta. And when shaft angle is 90 degree, then the sin 90 become 1, cos 90 become 0, so it become 1 upon g. Or for tan of gamma 2, it become g. I hope you get the concept. Thank you for watching video.